Hey everyone, I've taken all three courses of Monthly by Blanks, Ryan Tedder course, and the Charlie Puth course. You may have seen ads for these on Instagram or Facebook, and this video is a comprehensive review of each course to give you context to see if it's right for you, or maybe you want to take, you've already taken one, you want to take another one. Because I haven't really seen a comprehensive review yet about this on YouTube, so I want to talk about a few things. So one, I'll give a bit of context on each of the three courses that I took, some things I liked about it, some things I didn't like about it with respect to those teachers, Ryan Tedder, Charlie Puth, and Blanks. And then I'm going to talk about Monthly in general and what I really like about Monthly and then what I really don't like about Monthly to give you the context just to show you, is Monthly right for you? And should you take a Monthly course? And this is completely my perspective coming from it as a producer, a songwriter, and also a YouTuber who teaches people as well. So by no means am I saying that my word is law and that I'm right in everything about this. It's just my opinion and my context about this. I'm not here to shame or hate on Monthly. I'm gonna talk about a lot of things I really like about these courses, but then I'm gonna talk about some constructive feedback that I think they could take and some things you might be interested if you don't, if you're going to take this course. So let's get into the first one and talk about Blanks. So Blanks is a YouTuber. The course is called Write and Produce Pop Songs. Blanks is a YouTuber. He has millions of followers and he's famous for recreating pop songs in 1 hour or less. So the things I really liked about the Blanks course was it shows you, he teaches you how to get really fast at producing. The vibe of the course is to produce really fast and get ideas out. And it's really entertaining. He's funny, he's engaging. So I like that about the course, firstly. Another thing I really liked is he's a solid musician all around. He plays a bit of bass guitars, he plays drums, acoustic guitar, he plays electric guitar, plays synth, he plays piano. So there was a variety in his musicianship. He wasn't just narrowly focused on anything. Some of the things I didn't necessarily like was in general, the audio quality of the course in this one specifically. Like, he wasn't recording the direct output of Logic, so I think what was happening was he was picking up all the audio from one microphone, so his vocal audio and the audio output from his speakers. So what's happening there when you do that is basically if you're talking really quietly and then you press play on Logic, the sound can be really loud or vice versa. So there's not really a solid audio track in general throughout the whole course. So I found that just to be like not very helpful. If you're going to do a course on music production, you'd want to get the actual audio output coming right from Logic. And on the other courses, they did do that. So maybe this was like a learning curve for Monthly. Inside this course, there is three songs you make. You produce three songs over the month. So you do, basically you remake a cover song and then you remake one original song. And then over here you make an advanced original song, which is more or less the same original song. I did find the original song to be good, but more like of a medium meh kind of feeling. I wasn't amazed by them, but I wasn't like disappointed by them either. I just kind of left being like, not bad, a meh feeling. Now here are the sections to the course. You can see it covers a huge variety of things, everything under the sun of music production. I did find that like Blank's energy is super engaging, very vibrant, and that makes him very entertaining as a YouTuber, which I really, really do enjoy his YouTube videos. However, I found like as a someone who I'm trying to learn from, the vibe felt a bit rushed, like because he exuded so much energy, it just felt a bit rushed in a way of when he was trying to teach topics, and I didn't reassure me as a student that he was perhaps overly confident maybe in the things he was teaching. It felt like it was just rushed and he was a bit choppy in the way he taught the subject. That could be completely unjustified, and maybe that is, but it just didn't leave me as a student reassured that he was fully knowledgeable in all these topics. But that was just that's a complete subjective opinion there. Last thing that would be some constructive criticism on the Blanks course would be it's not really a course about teaching. The only teaching I found that he really did in this course was around music theory and songwriting. There were bits of things he did to teach, but a lot of this course was watch me do it and come along for the ride, be a fly on the wall. And then he would throw bits of teaching throughout the course there. And I don't mind that sometimes. I like the learning when you're a fly in the wall. But I actually, this was the first monthly course I came into, and I thought it would be more from the, let me teach you, let me be your teacher, and I'm going to explain everything. So this is very much more on the side of, you get taught some things, but you're more a fly on the wall of, here's my, in Blank's perspective, like, here's my way on how I write songs and here's how I do things. And you're kind of watching him do that. Let's get on to the second course here, the Charlie Puth course, which is the second monthly course that I took. It's called Pop Songwriting and Production. Again, in this course, you don't do three songs, you produce two songs. Charlie breaks it down into, like, make kind of a Charlie Puth style pop song. And then the second song is making a song that you would be uncomfortable making, so likely in a completely different genre. First thing that I really liked about the Charlie Puth course right away was he's just so incredibly talented. Like, his musicianship is just insanely high, that it's just awesome to see kind of a master at their own craft work, and how he just plays, you know, things, and how he moves over to the synthesizer and just plays something. He's a incredibly talented musician. So that's the first thing I really liked. The second and third thing was, because he's such a pro, it was super insightful to hear stories of how he makes hit songs. Like, his songs have hundreds of millions of views, and he's written songs that have, you know, over billions of streams. Him to actually talk about that, you see it from him. So you're getting, like, the raw data, the raw input from him on how those songs were made. That's really, really cool. Similarly to, like, the Blanks course, you are more of a fly on the wall for Charlie's process and his, how he starts a song from scratch. So I found that really cool, because he just does it how you would actually write a hit song. I feel like he didn't really change anything. He's super genuine about that. So I found that to be super insightful, but more on the fact that he doesn't necessarily teach. I'll talk about that in a bit. Another thing, he's incredible at, like, recording vocal harmonies and layering harmonies, using your vocal as an instrument throughout the production. Like, he makes his vocal a guitar too, and adds effects. So it's just the creativity he has to get your ideas thinking and what you can do with your voice, because he's a pianist and he knows, like, the piano and so the synthesizers really well. He doesn't play guitar, so he doesn't know the guitar well, so he teaches you how to record your voice as a guitar almost. So that kind of, like, out of the box creativity was super cool to see. Overall, he just seems like a really nice guy, friendly, genuine, caring guy. Like, I felt like I wanted to go have a beer with him after, because just seemed like a really nice guy. So overall, felt like he was the nicest guy in all the courses. It felt like he was the most calm, most genuine instructor out of all the three. A few things I didn't like about the Charlie Puth course was, he is so insanely talented that he's been so insanely talented for so long that it was hard for him to bring that level down to a beginner. So, for example, he would be like, oh, just add, like, that flat nine, or ooh, add the major seventh on that. If you don't know what that means, then it sounds just like a completely different language. So he would explain things in the way that, like, you knew musical theory in a way, and he would catch himself and try to bring it down and explain it differently sometimes. But I don't think that's his fault. He's just really talented. So I think maybe he forgot sometimes that to bring it down to, like, a kindergarten beginner level. I think if you went into this course as a complete beginner, you would find some of this being like some of it sounding like it's a completely different language. This course is very minimal focused on mixing and mastering. He outrightly says that he does not mix and master his songs. And he talks about, like, some of the best mixing engineers in the world, like Serba Guinea, and Manny is another one. I don't remember their last name. So he outrightly says that, so you can't blame him. But although Monthly does say that they will cover mixing and mastering, it's not about mixing or mastering in this course at all. Similarly to the Blanks one, this is even more maybe a fly on the wall to Charlie's songwriting process and how he writes hit songs, and less teaching. There is, again, some teaching here or there. The course isn't laid out in a teaching fashion. It's like, okay, let's make a beat, and then you watch Charlie make a beat. Like, he doesn't explain, like, what a kick pattern is, or where to put your snare hits, or, like, how to create a nice high hat patterns, or, like, what compression is, and, like, all, like, the educational aspects of songwriting and mixing, that kind of thing, you're not going to learn in this course. It's like, here's how I do it, watch me do it, be a fly in the wall, which is super cool, because you see a hit maker make a hit and the songs he makes are really cool, and you see it happen in action. But he's not necessarily teaching you everything. It's more like watch me do it and learn. Still, you learn a lot, you learn, but it's not through teaching. It's by just consuming and being a fly on the wall for that. Third course is write and produce hit songs with Ryan Tedder. So this was the third and final monthly course that I took. And similarly, you write a song, an original song, then you do another original song. The third one, it's cool. He collabs with another artist and teaches you how you can like collaborate with another artist. First thing I really liked about that, like Charlie, he's incredibly talented. His pedigree of hit songs is enormous. Ed Sheeran, Adele, it goes on. Like, tons of hit songs he's written, not to mention like his own band One Republic too. So incredibly talented person. The second thing that I really liked is he's a super strong generalist, plays a bit of guitar, plays drums a bit, plays keys a bit. He says outright too, he's not good at all those things. He's a generalist at everything. So I really like that he's out front about that kind of stuff, and it makes him seem more human in a way, because he's like, you can see he's actually not that good at playing guitar or at playing the keys, but then he does it and it sounds good. So it makes it more human. You're like, I can do that, you know? Versus when Charlie Puth is like so awesome, like a beautiful chord he played. And I'm thinking that's amazing, but if I can't do that, I'm not Charlie Puth. I don't know. I'm not a classical trained pianist, so I don't know those like beautiful chord shapes. With Ryan, it's just like simple stuff that sounds good. And he outright says he's just a generalist and he's not good at this stuff. So it makes him sound more human. The third thing I really liked about the Ryan course is it's super focused on songwriting and predominantly the melodic aspects. So not really about mixing, not really about mastering. It's all about the song for him. Especially the top line melody. You see how he goes and really dissects the top line melody, which is the vocal track, to get a perfect sounding song. Like his songs that he made are super cool. Like in general, like I feel like if he wrote those songs and they were in the monthly course, like he would probably go and pitch those songs. You know, he talks about, I'm pitching this song for Justin Bieber, sorry, or to Kane Brown. Like he talks from that perspective. So you're really seeing like, this is actually how he does it. Two constructive criticisms there was, like anyone here, he's not a teacher. He's a pro songwriter. So he does ramble at times a bit when he's trying to teach. You can see in his head, like he's trying to explain how to do it and teach you, but he's not a teacher. He's a songwriter. So I don't blame him for rambling a bit, but it is a constructive criticism because it is not very succinct because of his rambling. And the last constructive criticism is it's not about mixing or mastering again. It's noticeable that he's not a mixer or a master. He balances things and it makes the song sound good. But like Charlie Puth, he sends these songs to, I mean, he didn't say that outright, but I would assume he sends those songs to someone to be professionally mixed and mastered. So this course isn't really about mixing or the mastering. It's all about, in his course, about the song, the catchiness, and the songwriting. So last section, what's really good about monthly? And then what do I not like about monthly? First thing, the instructors are awesome. I mean, they're talented. They come as true professionals. So that's the first thing. They get really, really good instructors. Second thing is you get a full insight into what their actual songwriting process is. So you see how it's done. Not necessarily taught, but you see how it's done. Third thing is you see what plugins they're using. Like when Ryan is writing songs, he's like, I use this plugin on Apologize, or I use this synth on Ed Sheeran's Happier, or what, like, he didn't say those things, but it would come in with that kind of perspective. Or Charlie's like, I use this reverb on my songs. So like Valhalla Reverb, the Chris Lord Algies, all the Soundtoy plugins, they're like, we use this stuff. And it's just cool to see that. Lastly, it's just super cool to be a fly on the wall for these true professionals, especially the Charlie and Ryan, because they come with like world hits, many world hits that you just get to see how it happens. And they have all these cool like side stories of, you know, how they made hits, or they like talk about Max Martin and little tips they give them, or just little cool side added stories that you get with those two courses specifically. So what do I not like about monthly? The first thing is they're not teachers. So just because you're really, really good at something doesn't mean you're good at teaching the thing. Teaching and being good at something they're completely different. So I found that although they're amazing, they struggle to actually teach you the concepts. And that's what monthly is. Second thing is they jump over a lot of things and they assume you know these things. So like, let's record a guitar, or let's add reverb, or let's compress this sound a little bit. If you don't know how to record a guitar, add reverb, or compress a guitar, any of those things, then you might feel lost or overwhelmed in these type of courses because they don't explain really what that is. That's one thing. If you're a beginner, you might have trouble with that. Third thing is, I thought it would be more about also bringing the song together and talking a bit more about mixing and mastering and balancing that kind of thing. It's not about mixing or mastering. If you're looking for a mixing course or mastering course, these aren't the courses for you. Last thing is the monthly kind of classroom is you get feedback from other students. Although it's collaborative, you kind of get some you get to show your song to other students in the class, because I don't know how many students are in the class, to be honest, at one time. But the thing is, you get feedback from random other students, three people, and the feedback is not good because there are other students who are just learning. Like, I don't like the fact that you're getting feedback from someone who knows probably little or as much or less than you, because their feedback is usually like misguided. They're like, the kick drum is too loud or something, or like, it's just the feedback isn't specific, isn't solid to give you anything to go off of. So I just found that to be a bit of a waste of time, even for like me to try to give someone feedback. I don't know what kind of feedback they want. And it's part of the course. I found that just to be a little odd, trying to get feedback. You should really, really pay attention whenever you're getting feedback to who it is and what the advice they're giving you, because you don't want to take feedback from someone who's just a beginner. Of course, all the data you can get, the better, right? But you have to pay attention to who you're getting the feedback from. So overall, ranking the courses, I think the Ryan Tedder course would be my first pick, Charlie Puth course being my second pick, and the third course being Blanks. So is monthly right for you? Are these three courses right for you? Yes, they're right for you if you learn by seeing someone else's process. And if you have a bit of knowledge with your DAW, with music writing, with songwriting and production, you have a base level knowledge. I think these courses are good for you. Is this course good for you if you are a beginner, you don't know anything, and you learn by someone teaching you? You want to be explaining these topics. I wouldn't say these courses are right for you. Is it wrong to take them anyways? No. Go and take all the courses in the world. The more information, the better, because then you can figure out what you like and how you like to learn. However, it's more a question of budget and time prioritization, because if you don't have all the time to take these courses, or you don't have the budget, because they're at least, you know, average $200 a pop here, then I would suggest considering my suggestions of if you should take this course or not, depending on if it's right for you. That's my ramble on monthly, if you should take it or not. Let me know in a comment if you've taken the course, if you think I'm wrong, if you think I'm not. Let's have a discussion in the comments, and I'll see you in the next video.